2016-17, we have with us Mohammad Jamshed, a member Traffic Railway Board, and Hemant Kumar, member Mechanical Railway Board. Very warm welcome to both of you, sir, to our studio. So no increase in passenger fare, at the same time, a vision for a modern and a world-class rail base. It's both customer-centric and ambitious. What do you think, sir?
Oh, absolutely. I think I would consider this as one of the most comprehensive budget and a vision document, including a plan of action, in fact, for development and growth. Every aspect has been covered. All sections of society have been covered. No fare hikes, as has been indicated, but at the same time, there are brand and group of trains which are likely to be introduced and has been announced in the budget, which are covering practically every segment of the society, from Antyodaya Express to Tejas to Uday to Deen Dayalu coaches. We have just now heard the Honorable Prime Minister talking about it.
Right.
So it gives us a very, very clear direction for moving ahead towards a high growth path.
So you'd like to add something to that?
Yeah, I would like to say that as it was started last year, last year's budget was a vision for 5 years. No, it was not an annual budget.
Right.
So it has taken off from there, and while the whatever areas have been identified last year, they have been continued. Some new areas have also been identified this year, and I'm sure the slew of initiatives which have been taken will definitely see us in a better light.
Right, and let's talk about some of the initiatives, and especially several customer-oriented services like measures for smarter ticketing, Clean My Coach SMS service has been launched. Please tell us something about that, sir.
So this Clean My Coach service had been actually tried about 6 months back in one of the railways, where you simply give your Clean My Coach and give your PNR.
Right.
And then it locates, because there are several trains where we are having onboard housekeeping services.
Right.
So in case the train is covered by the onboard housekeeping service, the message goes to the janitor who is available on the
so one wouldn't
service.
Have to go around complaining, you just have
you
to
do not have to. You simply give a SMS,
and the
SMS will go to that person,
right,
and
right.
He will attend to you,
right,
and get a feedback.
Right.
So you'll get a feedback also that it has been done. So
right.
The circuit is complete after a satisfactory service compliance has been recorded.
Right. And so if you were to talk about special focus on senior citizens, women, and for the young, a lot of provisions are there for them. For women, I think about 33% reservation in reserved quota.
Oh, in fact, I would like to clarify that this 33% of reservation in quota is not in the train seats reservation. I mean, this is much bigger than that.
Okay.
This is a quota that he has been talking about when the minister announced about the catering services to be improved,
right,
and certain services to be transferred to IRCTC. And there are a slew of measures in that. And one of them is that when we have these small catering stalls at various small stations, and these are also allotted through a contract, in fact, to the people for running it, there would be a 33% quota for women in that.
Right. And for senior citizens, so often they complain that they don't get booking in the lower berths. Provisions for them as well?
I think this has been already, expanded.
It has been doubled, in fact. The number of berths reserved earlier for them were 2, in fact, it has become 4. So
right.
In every train, there would be about 120 berths for them.
Right. And so, a very interesting
lower
focus.
Berths,
right. And very interesting focus on porters. Uniform provision for soft skills is being given to them. How do you think it's going to, if you look at the overall picture of Indian Railways, how do you think it's going to add to the development of the railways?
Well, these coolies, in fact, will no more be called the coolies. Basically, they will be called the sahayaks. They will have a different kind of a uniform. They will be provided with the mobile trolleys.
Right.
And they can also be booked online, in fact. If
okay.
You are going to be at a station
okay.
And you need a porter there, that sahayak would be available to you. In
so
fact,
one wouldn't have to negotiate.
You don't have to negotiate at all. There will be prefixed costs for that.
Right. And so, if we were to talk about the numbers, Railway Minister has spoken about the investment target of 1.2 lakh crore and he hopes to generate about 1.84 lakh crore in revenue. Help us understand this vision in particular, especially when the fare had not been increased.
Yeah, although the fares have not been increased and also the freight, but the kind of rationalization in any case would be with us. In fact,
right.
We'll be undertaking the rationalization of fares and freights both during the year. However, we have pegged the freight loading at 1160 million tons, and this 1160 million tons will generate about 1,17,000 crores.
Okay.
At the same time, the passenger growth will give us about 51,000 crores, and rest will be coming from sundry and other coaching earnings, non-fare box earnings.
Okay.
So that is how this budget has been formed, and we will, it's a tough job, but we'll be working towards that, to achieving those kinds of revenues back to the railways.
Right, and in future, how do we see a practical application of cooperative federalism when states also play an important role in the development of railway across the country?
Yeah, absolutely. This is another idea. In fact, of last year it has started already. It's a PPP arrangement.
Right.
And this time it's not only a PPP arrangement, but also having special purpose vehicles,
right,
joint venture SPVs to be created with the states and Ministry of Railways. And these are project specific. If there are three or four projects which are already ongoing or have been sanctioned for that particular state, these two entities would join together and they would be able to take forward those projects and their timely completion.
Right, and Mr. Kumar, a more proactive use of technology seems to have been at the center of the budget this time. We learned about the high-tech centralized network of about 20,000 stations. Please tell us how the use of technology is being seen as a way of improving the railway services in the country, sir.
Technology has got many dimensions.
Yes.
One of the dimensions, as we have been noticing, is the use of social media.
Mm-hmm.
The messages that come on Twitter, almost daily thousands of messages come, they get forwarded to the authorities who are supposed to take action. I also keep on getting several messages.
Right.
And then whenever there is a need and help is provided to the customer, he certainly feels satisfied.
Right.
So that is one important, but that's not all. We have been talking about knowledge. In fact, we have knowledge portals also, which are sharing knowledge between amongst the railway people, because some of the technical information may not be available to other people.
Right.
So the technology is being used in a big way.
And sir, can you tell us something about what kind of measures are being taken for grievance redressal? Again, another issue that passengers face if they have an issue to complain about someone. It's difficult to, you know, locate the right person who is to take down the complaint. Any use of technology?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, even I would also like to add to your previous question that this technology, there will be about 20,000 screens at about 2,000 stations, but we should be conveying online information about not only about trains, but train arrival, departures, availability and location of coaches and everything. And there will be applications, in fact, which will be station specific for navigation, where exactly are the facilities located. We have already moved ahead in the direction of having paperless ticketing systems on the suburban sections. Similarly, on the grievances side, last year itself, in fact, there is a COMS. In fact, you have an application where from you can take a photograph and you can write your suggestion or complaint and send it directly to a central server. And this central server is provided, which is also connected with the divisional headquarters. So this information or a suggestion or action to be taken on an immediate basis is immediately passed on to the nearest railway station and action is taken.
Right, and so we're running out of time. The final question is about how do you see the new railway budget in the context of government initiatives like Make in India and Skill India? We see all the linkages coming together now.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I think on the Make in India and Skill India, the biggest thing that has happened, I think you would like to tell
yes,
them about Marhora and Malindra.
Yeah, actually, two projects had been sanctioned about 10 years back, but due to various reasons, because of misgivings from railway side, misgivings from the industry side, we were not sure about what is the real position of the other side.
Right.
But this year, within 2 months of the opening of the request for proposal, the two contracts worth 40,000 crores were awarded.
Okay. The locomotive factories.
Right. The two locomotive factories.
Yes.
One is a diesel locomotive factory. One is an electric locomotive.
40,000 crores.
40,000 crores. They were awarded within 2 months.
Right. Right, and thank you very much for all that input and information. Thank you very much for joining us in the studio today.
Thank you very
the
much.
Discussion. That's all
thank
the time
you.
We had in the discussion today. So the railway budget 2016-17 is out. No hike in fare, but a lot of interesting provisions there for the common man. Here we'll take a short break. When we return,